Do you want to make drop shadows in Canva but don't know how to go about it? Then grab a cup of coffee and sit back as I show you just how easy it is. So with your project file open, what we're going to do is create a drop shadow on an element that you can't already add a drop shadow to with inside of Canva. Canva is great, but it has its limitations here and there. And one of them is drop shadows. Photoshop can do drop shadows. Why can't Canva have drop shadows on all the elements? I don't know, but we're going to do a little workaround. So follow me. We're gonna do is add an element. I'm going to choose, make a thin oval shape here because I want this Chobani yogurt to be floating, not really grounded, I want it to be floating. So they have an oval here, but I think it's too ovally, if that's even a word. So I'm gonna choose this little slash line oval thing. We're gonna click on that and we're just going to expand that out a little bit. Awesome. And then I'm gonna come over here to the color and I'm gonna change it to a darker brown. I think a nice little tidbit here I'll add is a lot of people just add a black drop shadow and that's what makes it look a little bit off, makes it look a little bit, I guess, corny and not super polished. So whenever you see a drop shadow that looks really clean and looks really convincing, it's because they chose a color that matched the background or whatever the thing is grounded on. If you have a blue background, you're gonna choose a darker blue for your shadow. So here I just chose this brownish because this is a little bit of an off-white color. So with that chosen, what I'm gonna do is duplicate the canvas. So with that duplicated, what we're gonna do now is we're just going to isolate the shape that's going to be used as a drop shadow. And then there it is, it's just by itself. So we're gonna come over here to download. And as you can see, Canva has a transparent PNG option, but that's with their paid program and we're on a budget. So we're gonna do the workaround. So just come over here to the duplicated page, hit download. And then Canva is going to prepare that for you. And then come to Show in Finder or wherever your file lives on your computer. I'm gonna throw this on my desktop for now. And then now what we're gonna do is go to a website called remove.bg. And that's just going to remove your background. Come over here to upload, find your project file that you just exported. Okay, cool, and it's processing. And then awesome, there it is. And then just hit download. It's going to download again. Come over here, drop it to your desktop, remove the other one. That's not a transparent PNG. Go back to your Canva file. Awesome. Now we can just remove this file and then we can even remove this shape or element that we just had there in Canva. And then we're going to upload the transparent PNG. Come over here to your file. Canva's going to prepare that. And then we're just going to add it in there onto the canvas. Just grab one of the points and expand it out because remember this is a lower res image, but that's gonna be fine because we're gonna blur it out. And then we're just gonna kind of position it where we like. And then now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to adjustments and then from there, we'll just blur it out. There we go, it looks nice. 75% is fine, okay? And then we're going to lower the opacity to like, let's try 75%. Yes, that looks fine. No, let's go a little bit lower. Let's go 70. 65 is the golden number. There it is. And then I'm just going to adjust this to make it seem like it's really floating. And then I'm going to send it to the back a little bit. And there you have it. Thank you so much for tuning in here at Under Budget Marketing Design, a channel for understaffed marketers, small business owners, and do-it-yourselfers. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe as your support drives me to create more content like this. Thank you again, and I'll catch you in the next episode of Under Budget Marketing Design.